I got you.
Hey, Jenna. World medalist. Talk about it.
Hot damn. Hello. Hot damn. Long time in the making. Had a rough start. You know, took a pretty darn good loss in the first match, which, you know, it's been a long road for me. It's been truly a long road. Grief's been a tough battle, and it'd be easy to sit here and tell you all the technical things I did wrong in that match, but it was up here. It was a really hard mental day. I'm really proud that I was able to bounce back and get what I wanted to earn, you know. I truly thought of the brands and get the next best thing. That's what I kept telling myself, so it feels good to be here. Next year it'll be gold.
So this match, you really seem to have a good strategy. You got the points when you needed it. You knew where you needed to be. Talk about what it took to win this match, because that opponent had some dangerous abilities, right? I mean, and you were able to take the lead and add to it.
Absolutely. Anybody can be dangerous out here. It's anybody's ball game, kind of, you know. She could have been the world champ, right? So I knew that I needed to stay in a really good position, you know, take the risk when they were there on that shot. Couldn't force the takedown, had to get the push out. And yeah, just being Jenna out there, you know, the first match, I wasn't myself. And you know, that was heartbreaking because I trained so diligently for a gold medal, but I also put a lot of pressure on myself and I wanted to be perfect. I wanted to do everything for my mom, and I didn't realize how much weight that was holding me down almost. So I knew by doing it for me, it was really doing it for my mom. Instead of everything was all this pressure, I gotta do it for my mom. But at the end of the day, my mom wouldn't care if I was first or last, as long as I was Jenna out there. So that's really what it took to be myself.
Is the loss like almost a release of pressure for you? Because you looked excellent from then on.
Yeah, I knew, you know, this whole time it was gold or bust. I wanted to be a world champion. I knew I had the capabilities. I'd beaten Olympic and world champs, beaten plenty of world medalists, and I really wanted the gold medal. And so once that pressure was off, I had to get the next best thing. So yeah, definitely.
Looks like you found something in that 2-on-1 early, right? What did you feel there? Because it looked like you were just pushing around the mat with that.
Yeah, my coaches, you know, they say I can 2-on-1 anybody, you know. So I believed them. I believed what they were saying to me, and I knew it was going to work. You know, I was able to get to that Olympic trials. I was able to get to that world team trials, you know. So sometimes you got to go back to your roots. As much as you want to, you visualize, oh, I want to do this, or I want to do that. Like, sometimes we got to do what you know how to do out there. So, yeah, I kind of got there, and I was like, dang, it's kind of easy. You know, it's a lot harder training in the room, so.
Now, you've been to a lot of world competitions, but this time, you know, when you needed it, you stepped up and got it. Was there something that you did this year? I mean, your wrestling has really gone to the highest level since you've been competing at the senior level. What do you put as factors to help you get here?
Letting loose a little bit, you know. You want to win so bad, you're so tense. I had to let loose, and I had to take risk in the room. I guess that would be the best answer for you. I was used to wrestling very safe, beating people up in front headlocks, and I wasn't getting any better in the room. I wasn't making my teammates better, and I sure as hell wasn't getting myself better. So I needed to open up and take risks in the room. And then sure enough, I started finding success in single legs and high crotches, and I didn't even need the dang front headlocks. So taking risks for, you know, all those months, because we were at the World Class Athlete Program, we were off the mat for a long time for COVID, so I didn't have much training, and so I knew why waste a day trying to just do the basics. I really had to open up, let loose, and all of a sudden you do that for a few months, show up to Olympic trials, and now I'm getting stuff I, you know, never thought I would, and then just kind of carried that with me. So I would say taking risks, you know, leave the ego out there. You don't need any of that.
The German, after her match with you, I mean, two heart attack matches, basically. Were you watching? And what was that like?
I was distantly watching in pain. And I was like, Nina, come on, please. And, you know, the cool thing was, you know, because I've known Hemmer for the past 10 years, been at Junior Worlds together. And when I saw her after, I said, hey, thanks, man. And she said, I thought of you. And I said, oh, shit. Okay. And then I saw her at the weigh-ins this morning, and she was like, come on, you have to go get the bronze. You have to do it. And I said, oh, I know, man. I had a tough mom mental day yesterday. And she goes, I know. That's why you need to do it. So it's cool. You have those battles, but mutual respect. And, you know, thank goodness that she was able to get the job done. She's been in the game a long time. So heart attack matches, but what makes it fun.
So what What are you going to do to celebrate? I mean, like you said, long time coming.
Hanging out with these guys. The World Class Athlete Program, my coach, is going to get a good dinner. These guys have made me truly believe in the best. And, you know, the best thing was they were motivating me, getting ready for the competitions. But as soon as I lost, man, I felt the love grow times 10. And that made me feel so much more whole that these guys aren't just when it's easy to say that, yeah, I've made the world team. You know, they're there when I'm at my lowest, and that really made me come back stronger. So I'm hanging out with these guys for sure.
The team's wrestling outstanding. A bronze is a huge contribution to that. What's been the attitude around the team?
Man, we love each other. We are really, you know, we want to be the best in the world, you know. Japan's still absolutely killing it, and, you know, we want this, and we're chipping away. And, you know, it's tough on those guys that came straight from the Olympics, and I think the people who didn't go to the Olympics were trying to motivate them and just keep the team strong, because it's been a long few months for everybody with COVID and all this heartache. You know, everywhere you look, it's been a lot of hard things to deal with. So just supporting each other when adversity hits.
Well, hey, congratulations.
Thank you guys.
I mean, this is fantastic. Great job.
Thanks. Enjoy.